Hello students, in today's class we will learn about the illustration number 3. See the question. Nair gives you the following particulars of his income earned during the previous year. So the income is relating to the previous year. In that first one, interest on Indian company debenture rupees 16,000, interest on bank fixed deposit rupees 15,000, accrued but not received, income from agriculture in England rupees 50,000, of which 30,000 is remitted to India, income from house property in England deposited in a bank there rupees 25,000, profit on sale of building in Mysore received in England rupees 1 lakh, income from business in Singapore controlled from Bombay rupees 60,000, half of this is received in India, pension from former employer in Bombay received in England rupees 40,000, past untaxed profit of 1998 to 1999 year brought to India during the previous year rupees 80,000. Compute the total income if he is a ordinarily resident, not ordinarily resident and non-resident. So here we have to compute the total income in the three cases. So let's see which all the income is taxed in the hands of ordinarily resident or in the hands of not ordinarily resident and non-resident. So see the first one, interest on Indian company debenture. So interest on Indian company means here it is taxable in the hands of all the three cases. Interest is taxable. If it is dividend from Indian company, then it is exempt. Interest on Indian company is taxable. Interest is taxable. Then it is taxable in the hands of three cases. If he is ordinarily resident, it is taxable. Not ordinarily taxable and non-resident also taxable. Second one, interest on bank fixed deposit rupees 15,000, accrued but not received. So this here the place is not given, means it is assumed that it is a fixed deposit is in India. So interest on fixed deposit, he received an interest on bank fixed deposit, not received, it is accrued but not received. Even if it is accrued also, we have to write it is a income, Indian income, we have to write in the three column, taxable in the all the cases, ordinarily resident, not ordinarily resident and non-resident. Income from agriculture in England, income from agriculture in England 50,000, of which 30,000 is remitted to India. So means this is a agricultural land situated in outside India, so it is a foreign income, taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident, of which 30,000 is remitted to India. It is means it is not taxable in the hands of not ordinarily resident and non-resident. So only 50,000 rupees is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next, income from house property in England deposited in a bank there, means it is a foreign income, so it is taxable only in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next one, profit on sale of building in Mysore received in England rupees 1 lakh. So profit he is received from a sale of building in Mysore. So building is situated in Mysore and the profit is received in England. Means building is situated in Mysore, means the income is earned in India. So it is taxable in the hands of all the three cases. Next, income from a business in Singapore controlled from Bombay. Income from a business in Singapore make it correct, it is Singapore. So income from business in Singapore, it means foreign income, it is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. 60,000 is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next, controlled from Bombay means controlled from India, so it is taxable in the hands of not ordinarily resident. 60,000. Next, half of this is received in India, so half of this received in India means in the half means how much, 30,000 is taxable in the hands of non-resident. Next, pension is from a former employer in Bombay received in England. So former employer in Bombay, so he is a employer in Bombay, means it is an Indian income, accrued in India. So 40,000 is taxable in the hands of all the three cases. Past untaxed profit 1998 brought into India during the previous year, so it is not relating to this current previous year, it is a past year profit, so it is not taxable in the hands of all the three cases. So simple problem, you have to solve by yourself. Next one, illustration number 4, problem number 4 or illustration number 4. See the question. From the following information, compute the gross total income or total income or taxable income of Mr. Amarnath for the previous year 2019-20. If he is a resident, second one not ordinarily resident and non-resident. So they have given the information. First one, profit from a business in Baghdad received in India rupees 10,000, income from house property in Burma deposited in a Indian bank there rupees 8,000, income from agriculture in Bangladesh remitted to India rupees 12,000, profit from business in England rupees 25,000. This business is controlled from Delhi. Income accrued in India but received in England rupees 15,000. Pension received in London for the services rendered in India rupees 15,000. Profit from a business in Kanpur received in Mumbai rupees 16,000. Income from agriculture in Nepal rupees 18,000. Income from business in USA 75% received in India rupees 30,000. Profit from sale of capital asset in Canada 50% is remitted to India rupees 18,000. Salary for the services rendered at the Indian embassy in UK received there from government of India rupees 20,000. Remuneration received from an Indian company for services rendered in Singapore credited to his bank account in Singapore rupees 20,000. Next one, salary from an Indian employer for services rendered in South Africa rupees 15,000 directly deposited by employer in his bank account in India. Next one, dividend received from an Indian company in London rupees 9,000. It is rupees, I guess. Rupees 9,000. Next, interest on POSB account rupees 3,000. Dividend from French company received in London rupees 6,000. Income from business in Sri Lanka but control from India remitted to India rupees 15,000. Gift from friends on the occasion of marriage anniversary worth rupees 60,000. Past untaxed foreign income brought into India during previous year rupees 20,000. So this much is the information he is given. From this we have to find which all the income is taxable in the hands of a resident, ordinarily resident, which all the income is taxable in the hands of not ordinarily resident and non-resident. Resident is nothing but ordinarily resident. Now I'll explain the question. So we have to compute gross total income or taxable income when he is a resident, not ordinarily resident and non-resident. So first one, profit from business in Baghdad received in India. So income is received in India, 10,000 is taxable in all the three cases. Income from a house property in Burma deposited in a bank, Indian bank there. So it is a foreign income. House property in Burma deposited in an Indian bank there, so it is taxable only in the hands of first one, ordinarily resident. Here, deposited in an Indian bank, the Indian bank is situated there only, so it is a foreign income. Not the income is not accrued in India or income is not received in India, so it is foreign income. It is taxable only in the hands of first one, ordinarily resident. Income from agriculture in Bangladesh. Agriculture land is situated in Bangladesh, remitted to India. So land, where is the land? Land is from income from agriculture in Bangladesh means land situated in outside India. Remitted to India means income is remitted to India, it doesn't matter. So where is the foreign income accrued or received is in the out of Bangladesh itself. So 12,000 is taxable only in the hands of ordinarily resident. So remitted to India is doesn't matter. If that income is remitted to India means it is not mean that it is received in India or accrued in India. Remitted means they just brought that amount to India. So that is not taxable in the hands of not ordinarily resident and non-resident. Next one, profit from business in England, rupees 25,000. This business is controlled from Delhi. So profit from business in England, foreign income, taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident, 25,000. Next, this business is controlled from Delhi, so it is taxable in the hands of not ordinarily resident. Then it is not taxable in the hands of non-resident. If it is received in India, then it is taxable in the hands of non-resident. So now it is taxable only in the hands of first two column. Ordinarily resident and not ordinarily resident. Next one, income accrued in India but received in England. Accrued is in India, so 15,000 is taxable in all the three column. Pension received in London for the services rendered in India. So services rendered means income accrued in India, so it is taxable in all the three cases. Profit from business in Kanpur received in Mumbai. received in Mumbai, so it is taxable in the hands of all the three cases. Income from agriculture in Nepal, so foreign income taxable in the hands of only ordinarily resident, not in the other cases. Income from business in USA, business is USA, so 30,000 is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next, 75% received in India, so out of 30, only 75% we have to take under second column and third column, like this one. Income from business in USA, 75% is received in India. Since it is a foreign income, 30,000 is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next, 75% is received in India. So only 75% we have to take under not ordinarily resident and non-resident. Next one, profit on sale of capital asset in Canada, 50% is remitted to India. So sale of capital asset in Canada, so it is foreign income, 18,000 taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next, we have to check whether it is taxable in the hands of not ordinarily resident and non-resident. Just here they have given 50% is remitted to India. Remitted to India, it is, does not mean that it is accrued or received in India. So it is not taxable in the hands of not ordinarily resident and non-resident. Only in the hands of ordinarily resident it is taxable. Next one is salary for services rendered at the Indian embassy in UK received there from government of India, rupees 20,000. So this is the salary for the services rendered at the UK. Rendered is Indian embassy in UK and received also there, earned and received also there from a government of India. So this Indian embassy of UK is owned by government of India, from government of India. So it means it salary in the it is income is accrued from deemed to be earned from Indian India. It is deemed to be accrued in India, so it is taxable in the hands of all the three cases. Since it is government of India, it is this one accrued, where it is accrued, Indian embassy in UK, so this is from government of India, so it is taxable in the hands of all the three cases. Next, remuneration received from an Indian company for services received in Singapore credited to his bank account in Singapore, rupees 20,000. So here remuneration received from an Indian company, from an Indian company, remuneration received for the services rendered in Singapore. Services rendered in Singapore and credited to bank account, received also in Singapore. Rendered Singapore, received also Singapore. So it is taxable only in the hands of ordinarily resident, like this one. Interest from foreign branch of Indian bank. So if it is received outside India, taxable only in the hands of first column. So that is similar to this one. Remuneration received from an Indian company for services rendered in Singapore. So this one is a branch is situated in Singapore and the amount also received also in Singapore. So it is taxable only in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next, salary from Indian employer for services rendered in South Africa. Indian employer, he is Indian employer, 15,000 is taxable in the all the column. Directly deposited by employer to his bank account in India, so 15,000 taxable to all. Next, dividend received from an Indian company. Dividend from Indian company is exempt. This one is exempt for all the cases. Interest on POSB account, post office saving bank account, rupees 3,000 is given. Up to 3,500 is exempt. So 3,000 is exempt. Next, dividend from French company received in London. Dividend from French company means it is a foreign company. Dividend from a French company. Dividend from foreign company is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. It is a foreign income, only in the hands of ordinarily resident it is taxable. Indian company dividend is exempt. Foreign company is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident. Next one, income from business in Sri Lanka but controlled from India, remitted to India. So business is in Sri Lanka, so the 15,000 is taxable in the hands of ordinarily resident, controlled from India, so again 15,000 is taxable in the hands of non-ordinarily resident. Remitted to India, it doesn't matter, so it is not taxable in the hands of non-resident. Next one, gift from friend is taxable on the occasion of marriage anniversary is taxable. If it is marriage function, then it is exempt. If it is marriage anniversary, then it is taxable. So exempt is up to 50,000 is exempt. Balance, if it is amount exceeds 50,000, then entire amount is taxable. So this is 60,000 means above 50,000. So 60,000 entire amount is taxable. So for all the three cases. Past untaxed foreign income brought into India is not relating to previous year, so it is not taxable. So exempt cases, see, Indian company dividend exempt, POSB exempt, then past untaxed, this one exempt, gift taxable. So this also solution you have to try to solve by yourself.